In its fight against the sporadic resurgences of COVID-19, China sticks to its dynamic zero-COVID policy. Experts say the policy is necessary and effective for the country with a population of some 1.4 billion and also benefits the global fight against the virus as well as economic recovery.
China has, contributed immensely to control this pandemic, not only nationally but also globally. And I'm sure all Chinese have done, Chinese people, Chinese government have done quite well actually in controlling the pandemic.
It's very difficult to respond as China responded. It's a very ideal response. It worked. It's not only worked for China, it really saved the world. China did contain the virus and is still doing the same thing.
Chinese government has previously been very careful to balance the economic and health requirements. The government has also come up with very enabling policies, including stimulus packages to support industry players, to ensure that production does not slow, to ensure that the industrial capacity of China is unhampered. I think that the Chinese economy is still going to remain strong and a major contributor to global economic wellness and stability and recovery from COVID-19, as well as the conflict-induced economic challenges from the Russia-Ukraine confrontation.
China's role has become even more significant in the economic recovery of many countries, especially those countries trading with China. And through China, long-term sustained growth, being the top trading partner, export market, import supplier, and a major source of foreign investment technology for my country and even ASEAN. I think in this area, China will be able to help other countries who are recovering from the economic devastation of the economy of the COVID-19 pandemic. So these are areas where China becomes very much relevant as we bounce back from the pandemic.